Alright guys, we will be getting started here in a second. I hope you all can hear me. We're on a new computer, so things might be a little weird tonight. We'll have to see how everything goes. Joie, how are you doing tonight? Good, good. Go ahead and get things pulled up. Glad you can hear me. Let's see if we can hear in the game.
It is good to see you.
Not too bad. Been very tired today. Didn't get good sleep last night. So I'm hoping to get more. And my nephew was apparently sending me voice texts. So I was getting distracted by that. Let's see. Have nothing to do. Oh, wait, we have a mail.
So I guess we Greetings, Master. I cleaned the vessel from stem to stern in your absence. You can smell the difference.
I can smell the difference. Oh, Lord Rathari. Tribute. Oh, yeah, that's right. I hope the stream is stable tonight. It seemed like it blinked out for a second for some reason, so, apologies if that happens again. I hope it doesn't. You know how it is. New stuff. Lord Rathari. I have respected your terms of banishment. As far as the Empire is concerned, Lord Rathari is no more. In solitude, my meditations are haunted by our last battle. I replay every feint and devastating strike, searching for an excuse for my defeat. There is only one answer. You are the superior Sith. But strength can be a liability. Your master is bloated with paranoia and hatred for anyone he deems a threat. One false step and Barriss will move against you. When that day comes, you'll beg for mercy you showed me. But Barriss will not grant it. Oh, look, he sent us the philosophy of the Sith code. That's very nice. Yeah, I don't know what's going on with things tonight. I've been having issues. I'm wondering if it's like the network card or something. On my end. I have to go to...
Better.
Okay, good. Alright. I'm gonna just swap loadouts. I must have 15 inventory slots open. Well, fine. Then go sell some stuff.
Hey, I can use the rest.
Can I now change combat styles? Now, can I?
You're good to go.
Did you see me? I was invisible. I'm like, sorry, no cuts. You need to go fight yourself. was worth it.
What seems to be the trouble, Hiroshio? Tell me why you're so concerned.
Master Carr, you promised we would be undetected, but the ship we've been tracking for you is here.
Calm your fear, Hiroshio. It will not serve you. I will speak with your visitor when the time comes.
Expect the conversation to be short, Jedi.
Okay. You never told me we'd be tracking a Sith.
You were provided the details necessary to perform your duties. Now please, remain quiet. Sith, I presume you are Darth Barriss's new apprentice. I am Jedi Master Norman Carr. Do you know me?
Will you be disappointed if I don't?
I have a long history with your master. Barriss and I like to keep tabs on each other, so when I heard of a new apprentice, I investigated. These men were merely monitoring the equipment, following orders. There's no need for bloodshed here.
My quarrel is with you, Jedi. These men need not suffer.
Your temperance is remarkable. Hiroshio, please leave with your men immediately.
Thank you. Thank you, Master Carr. And you as well, Sith.
Don't mention it.
Now that they're safe, I'll speak plainly. I know Barriss has spies, and I know you were sent to extract two of them before they could be exposed. But I'll soon have the proof I need. Barriss's spies can't hide for long.
Your pupil's powers are a sham. She is leading you on a witch hunt.
You know more than I thought. Barriss, no doubt, is after my Padawan. How unfortunate. I've kept her identity and location a secret. So you and your master are just feeling your way in the dark. But my Padawan is of supreme importance to me in the Jedi Order. I will not let harm come to her.
Well, that's very brave of you.
I mean her no harm, Master Carr.
Please excuse me if I don't believe you. Forgive the earlier deception, Sith. But now that Hiroshio and his men have escaped harm, I must neutralize you immediately. These troopers are among the Republic's finest. Surrender, and the Jedi Council will be lenient.
I find that preposterous.
You leave me no choice. Men, take the Sith in by any means necessary.
Well, we tried. Everywhere. Hold on. I see something I must blow up. This very, very exciting music going on in the background. That's all the ones I see. My job here is done.
It seems Darth Barriss has found himself a singularly vicious weapon in you. This experience has given me valuable insight. I'll be prepared for you next time, Sith.
I was holding back. I fought them with one eye closed.
You cannot get under my skin with your antics. My place is by my Padawan's side, teaching her the ways of the Force and honing her talents. I will do everything in my power to keep her hidden from you.
Wear yourself out.
Until we meet again.
Bye! I can't use this right now. Well, why not? It's right there and it's blue. Now I want to go find those other two consoles to blow up. There's one right there. He'll see me? One in here? Yep. Think this is the way out? Bye, boys. Have fun. I'm going the wrong way. So new patch on Tuesday, guys. You excited for anything for the new mini map? I keep going in circles. There's literally on the map a spot that says station entrance. You know, I'm pretty sure a mini map, a new map will not change my sense of direction at all. Hey Scribbles, how are you doing?
Apprentice, now that Noman Carr realizes that we seek his Padawan, there's no time to waste. He claimed the girl on her home planet of Alderaan, and she trained on Tatooine. I have agents on both planets digging up leads. Find the people who know this girl. Someone means enough to her to make her come out of hiding.
You know, I'm starting to get the feeling maybe we're the bad guys, Darth Barriss? I don't know. Got lost in our own base. Yeah, me too. I know that feeling.
Sounds like a lot of guesswork to me.
Do not doubt me, Apprentice. The girl must have family on Alderaan, and I have theories about what lies on Tatooine. Well, I am confident this is how we will prevail.
Must she have...
The Padawan's training is incomplete. She is susceptible. The anguish you cause will flush her out, and you will kill her and her master.
You know, that seems a little extreme. The order is given. Show her the dark side. I'm ready to be tested. Cool. Love all of these options.
Perhaps the Padawan can be turned.
Her power would be a great asset, yes. Put through enough torment, she may reveal her base nature. But we must be cautious. The danger she represents is extreme. As long as she lives, she is a threat. Seduction to the dark side should be left to masters. If there is even a sliver of doubt in your heart, it can backfire.
I am pure.
My heart is immune to doubt.
Don't deny doubt. It can feed as well as any other emotion. You have yet to face a Jedi Master. Their righteousness and passionless demeanor is nauseating. And Noman Carr is no ordinary master.
Okay, Edgelord.
Confronting him, you will find profound fortitude and hate, or you will falter.
Save the rhetoric. Let me get to work.
Learn to heed my wisdom, or you will die. Be off, then. Tatooine and Alderaan await. Discover this Padawan's identity and destroy her.
You know, you're not a very nice man, Barriss. Just saying. Let's turn on subtitles, perhaps. Yes, Barriss and Noman Carr absolutely talked about each other like exes. Hi, Quinn. How are you doing?
Yes, my lord.
Okay, cool. Good talk.
The sands of Tatooine await you, apprentice. I've gleaned much since our interrogation of the Republic agent here on Dormant Kaas. I am certain Noman Carr brought this gifted Padawan to Tatooine to train with a legendary master named Yarnlok. Years ago, I urged the Dark Council to hunt down and destroy this Jedi. They refused, and Yarnlok went into hiding on Tatooine.
Yarnlok. All of the sands, yes. Every single grain of it. For me? Let's see.
Now I have to mop up the Council's mistake.
It won't be the last time. The Dark Council often lacks foresight. Yarnlok is the one who brought the Padawan's powers into expression. Now they share a special bond. Find him and destroy him.
What do you hope to achieve by doing this?
Noman Carr shelters his prize. So we will draw her out by destroying everything she loves.
Again, this seems really
extreme. My servant
Sharrat
Biv will guide you. She's eccentric, an acquired taste. But give her the benefit of the doubt.
I'll give her what she needs to do the job at hand.
And I'm telling you, what she needs is your tolerance. That is all.
Let's go find this Yarnlok. That's not the exit.
Sands of Tatooine welcome you. I am Sharrat Biv.
Hi.
Our lord and master Darth Barriss bid me to impart my knowledge of this planet and help you track down the Jedi Master Yarnlok.
It's a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
I will be your compass.
Okay.
You will find Master Yarnlok by tracing the path the Padawan and her master took. I can tell you where they started. I followed them to the forbidden lair of the ancient sand demon, a terrible beast. The Padawan left her weapons and entered alone. Impossibly, she returned unscathed.
She brought the Force. It is a powerful weapon.
I have witnessed the power of the Force, but this goes beyond wonder. The Sand Demon is the fiercest creature on this planet. You don't just walk into its lair and return without a scratch.
Like Mordor.
I investigated further. The beast was there, also undamaged. And what's most perplexing, its skin was glistening.
That is very confusing. Was it bleeding?
Not blood as from a wound. Glisten. More like the layer of living gel one is born into the world covered in.
Ew.
What happened in that cave is a mystery. As is where the Padawan and her master went afterwards. There is one man on Tatooine who might be able to explain. Isabeau Jeef.
That
is as old as the sand. Part madman, part soothsayer.
Better not be a waste of time.
If anyone can deduce why the Padawan sought the Sand Demon, it is he.
Isabeau?
It will not be easy to speak with Jeef. The small farming settlement where he lives has been overrun by Exchange thugs. The Exchange hates the Empire for running them out of Mos Eila. They will allow me to pass, but they'll attack you on sight.
I see no problem here.
Then I will meet you at Isabeau Jeef's hut.
Wait. We are absolutely using the wrong thing. You gotta have the evil party bus. Although, I think we're being drowned out by the extremely dramatic music. Alright, soundtrack, do you? There we go. Background music is trying to be the foreground, yeah. It's trying to come back. We don't need mysterious Tatooine music. We have all the music we need. Oh my god, fine. Whenever you're done, soundtrack. You're probably gonna have to remix everything. New install and all. I love the echoiness. Exchange doesn't mind.
The world is weeping, and the tears evaporate in the heat of our sins.
I think you mean from the heat of our sons, Isabeau.
No, child. There is a dark presence newly arrived on Tatooine.
It's me,
Sith.
Darth Doom.
You made it. The hostiles outside were no match for you, I see.
No, they were not hostile at all. We all got along fine.
They tried to stop me. They failed.
No.
Failure can be contagious and hard to dispel once contracted. You are the Seeker Sharak spoke of. You wish to understand the Jedi's purpose in the lair of the Sand Demon.
Sure.
You see it correctly.
My eyes may be aged and failing, but my mind sees.
Please, Isabeau, make haste. Tell my friend what you know. I will remain here after to hear your wisdom.
Fine. Gather close. Few are aware that Tatooine was once a place of positive Force energy. Jedi made pilgrimages here to renew and purify.
How does that
The sands work? Speak of a ritual called yes. the Demon's Blood. This is likely what the Jedi that Sharak witnessed was engaged in.
Explain this ritual.
The Demon's Blood. A Jedi seeking enlightenment would cover himself in fresh Sand Demon blood and enter the village of the Savage Ones. Cowering before the Demon Slayer, the Savage Ones would reveal the path to self-discovery and to that which the Slayer seeks.
Wait, what?
According to Sharak, the Padawan did not slay the beast.
There must be another way to bathe in the beast's blood. But you'll have to discover that for yourself, if you care to.
Actually, I'd have another question. The Savage Ones?
The world is...
Let's just get down
to do the business. You are the Seeker Sharak spoke of.
You
simply fussed.
Explain this, Richard. Do you mean the Sand People?
Tatooine makes most who come here savage. And the Sand People have been here all along.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Isabeau, as I told you, the girl faced the beast but left it unwounded.
There must be another way to bathe in the beast's blood. But you'll have to discover that for yourself, if you care to. To know where this Jedi girl went, you'll have to perform the ritual yourself, and then see if the Savage Ones speak.
It's not much to go on, but it will do.
That is everything I have. If everything is not much, then perhaps nothing is everything.
Here are the coordinates you will need.
He's so wise.
After you face the Sand Demon, I will meet you at the Sand People compound. If the legend is true, and the Sand People have something to offer you, I wish to see it with my own eyes. I'll humor Isabeau while you confront the Sand Demon. Then I will pick up your trail and meet you at the Sand People compound.
First, you must face the demon in his lair, then descend upon the Sand People. Only then will your path become clear.
How does she know anyway? Oh, wait. There we go. Not at all. And there's no music to soothe us either. Just the snapping of womp rats at our heels. just like trying to imagine, like, you know, how this like goes down in universe. Dane just pulling up these
displaying all authorized destinations.
Apollo's very sadly Apollo trying to
confirmed.
The music in the party bus. Trying to pretend he's not Barris's little bitch. I think my map's too big. Hold on. There we go. Now I'll remember to launch the party bus. My text bigger. I don't necessarily want the map the size of. We've arrived. I'm not in combat. Oh. Feel free to help out anytime you want. Can't wait to see what a sand demon looks like. Sounds fun. Although hopefully he doesn't have to give birth. I'm not really sure what that description was that she told us, but it sounded wholly unpleasant. Either way. It's a spider! I'm sorry, an ancient sand demon, what?
Can we talk for a second? I really don't have a good feeling about this.
I'll make you feel better later.
We're about to face a monster that can swallow us whole. I'm thinking, if the Jedi perform the demon blood ritual without a fight, there must be a way we can too. As a favor to me, could we please get through this without mixing it up with the sand demon?
We'll see, Vet. I'll try.
That's all I ask. Thank you. Looks like it's showtime. The monster's caught a whiff of us. I'm ready to back you up if it goes badly.
That's very kind of you. Now sit. Sit, good sand demon, incensed at my intrusion. Should I stand stoically or step back submissively?
I yield to you, demon.
Oh, nope. Alright. Guess we'll just stand stoically.
I'm thinking, as a favor to me.
I was already planning on doing that.
Oh, good. That's a relief. Looks like it's showtime.
Desert monster, I stand my ground. I will not run.
You tell him. We confuse the sand demon. I'm gonna put my hand out to be sniffed.
See? I am not your enemy.
Okay. We'll try one more time.
I was already planning.
Oh, good. Sir.
Desert monster. I stand my ground. I will not run.
Alright, fine. We'll stare at
Look down. Into my eyes, beast.
That's a good sand demon. I want to pet him.
You are now my pet.
Okay, fine. I just wanted to pet him. I didn't want to, like...
I'll make you
feel a little bitch about it.
Look into.
Meditate.
We are one at peace.
You sense trust. Well, that's unexpected.
The beast sleeps. Now, let us see what transpires.
You okay there, Matt?
Gross. This thing went to sleep and shed its skin. It's oozing blood and nastiness all over the place. And the smell. Oh, Cag, we're gonna stink for days. What if it never wears off?
It will be all right, Vet.
I sure hope you're right. I take a lot of pride in my hygiene. So,
we'll just have to take
let's
lots
get
of
out
showers.
Of the stink pit, huh?
Calm yourself, Vet.
Okay. I'm trying.
If not for the tall tales of desert nomads and a few grainy satellite reconnaissance images, Tatooine's so-called sand demon would be considered a myth. Jawas say the sand demon is feared by all other life on the planet, including the mighty crate dragon, for the sand demon is the crate's only predator. Really? That thing? Okay. Some stories report that the beast is capable of sand swimming, gliding underneath the surface of the desert as it were water. Others claim it bores through rock, using its hardened, talon-like legs. Cave paintings suggest the sand people believe the sand demon devours the life essence of its victims, growing stronger and tougher with each kill. They depict stories of the centuries-old demon that have become immune to any injury, a warning heeded by even the most skeptical outsiders. Where's my sand demon friend? He just disappeared. Alright, now that we have bathed, you must follow the Padawan's path. Alright, I guess we're just heading back out? Bigando. They're just running. They're not hurting nobody. They be scared of my invisible self.
Trailed and observed your descent here. I could not believe my eyes. The sand people all ran from you. What transpired inside the sand demon cave that makes this so?
Well, it was really, really gross, and I'm pretty sure it's because we stink really badly.
I have no idea why the sand people ran.
Now that I see you close up, I can guess. You have the demon's blood all over you. Its essence follows you. Now, Isabeau said that this is where your path will be illuminated. But there doesn't seem to be anything here. Wait! Oh. On your guard, Offworlder. One of the sand people approaches.
Shaman cowers and bows before you and holds out a weapon. Well, cool.
I will respond in kind.
Sharak.
I've never seen one of the sand people approach an outsider in peace.
Well,
this parchment the sand person brought is remarkable. It is a crude but very clear map of the desert. It marks a door carved into the wall of the Desert Wound Ravine. But I've mapped this ravine, and there is no such door.
Tell me anything else important about the area.
I can tell you that humans are very low on the food chain there. The ravine marks the farthest I or anyone I know of has dared venture. Here are the coordinates. I will follow stealthed, using the dune's shadows.
Think first of your own safety, and do not follow if it becomes too harrowing.
Your concern is appreciated. Darth Barriss enlisted my services to be scout and lookout, and I intend to do my job.
Yeah.
Head deeper into the desert, and you will find the Desert Wound Ravine. Safe journey.
Not being attacked for once. I'll run with you guys. Come on. It's a race. Actually, I'm wondering if I can just save myself a little time. I didn't need to leave that cave at all.
Cave in.
Jaunty tune. Oh, I could have taken a, speeder here. You guys wanted to see the crowd anyway, right? Bad happened here. Or it's happening. Hmm. so pretty in here.
This is either a mirage or a trap set by a nasty underwater monster. Or both.
Take a good, long look, Lightweight. See the man you're supposed to be. I'm the embodiment of your true potential. I am what you could be if you had the guts to follow the dark path more faithfully.
But I am dark!
I knew I was good-looking, but this is ridiculous. Vanity becomes you. But your looks will do you no good unless you heed my words. Cease your merciful tendencies and embrace the full meaning of the dark side of the Force, or you will be destroyed. Exactly how will I be destroyed? There are any number of disasters you are flirting with.
But that's what I do best, is flirt.
You are Sith. You walk among Sith. The stench of the light in you will be like rot in their nostrils. Darth Barriss will smell it on you and will strike you down without mercy.
No, that's just
mercy.
Sand demon blood. That's what you're smelling. Or sand demon period blood? I'm not really sure what happened, to be honest.
I'm not worried about Barriss. You are foolish. Barriss already plots against you. The light blinds you to the ill will growing from your fellows. Barriss and the other Sith will have the advantage of deception. And the power of the strongest forces in the galaxy. Passion, rage, love. The light shuns and denies these things. Passion, rage, love, those things only cloud judgment. I'll take my chances. You're turning your back on true power. Think about it. Barriss has seen his own destruction at the hands of this Padawan.
And?
What if you can seduce her? Claim this Padawan for yourself. Corrupt her to the dark, control her, and add her power to yours. A master of the dark side could turn this Padawan, and then you can destroy Barriss and claim everything he has. I'm not convinced. Fool, one day the darkness that you reject will...
Hold on, I want to try that another option.
Exactly how there you are. I'm not worried. You are lad. Passion. You're what? She and I will join forces, and together we will fight the forces of dark.
Uh-huh.
Fool. One day, the darkness that you reject will overwhelm you.
Probably. You're not a very accurate reflection. I don't think you're really these, if you come to think of it. Handsome. Phony.
A chance. Let's talk.
Well, that was unusual.
You have proven your way strong and viable. With this victory, our essence has been purified.
But I was already
in the clarity
purified.
Of this communion. A vision of our destiny on Tatooine appears. Can you see it too? An encampment hidden in the farthest reaches of the desert, past a rock formation called the Forbidden Pass.
Sounds great.
Forbidden Pass. What an ominous name.
There is no doubt this is where the Padawan went. This is where the Great Master helped her powers become expressed. The image fades. Find the Forbidden Pass and confront Master Yonlok beyond it.
Yonlok.
Our journey on this planet ends there. Farewell.
Well, bye, you handsome devil. He said that, so he's just like, man, I'm really attractive.
I cannot believe what I just witnessed. Did you just tell yourself to venture beyond the Forbidden Pass?
It's not polite to eavesdrop.
I only just arrived. It was not my intention to listen in. I am chilled to the bone. The desert beyond the Forbidden Pass is an area that no one can survive.
It's an exhaustion zone?
Even the sand people dare not go. You mustn't go.
Your concern for me is unnecessary.
This is not some silly superstition. Those who go beyond the Forbidden Pass are never seen again. I will not. I cannot follow you there.
You've done enough, Shorik. Thank you.
That is kind of you to say. I told Lord Barriss I would see your mission through, but I never imagined it would come to this. With a heavy heart, I give you the location of the Forbidden Pass. I am ashamed that my cowardice paralyzes me. I fear I will never see you again.
I'll be fine. I don't plan on dying in this desert.
If you plan to cross the Forbidden Pass, that is exactly what you are doing.
Well, what a handsome top. It's in the Dune Sea. What a surprise. Man, Tatooine was quick. Perhaps I'll take the speeder this time. You know, that little rock outcropping up there kind of looks like a face. You see it? The eyes and the mouth. Not a very handsome face, but a face nonetheless. Every time I see a reel now, I went on so many of those ingredient hunts, I immediately like think I need to go kill the reel. Although only the sand skimmer ones I found. Here it is. Maybe we can talk this through nicely.
Master Yonlok, the Sith you've been tracking is upon us. Retreat to safety. I will take the intruder on.
No, Yuli. Control your feelings. Stand at my side. I will face this trespasser. Come no farther, Sith. I have been aware of your pilgrimage here. You are a fascinating and contradictory example of your order.
Yeah, that's what I try.
I know why you've come. Master Nomenkar's Padawan threatens you somehow. You seek to flush her into the open and silence her.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Don't insult me, child. You are an open book to me. You are here for her. I know it. She came to me for guidance, and the bond we struck was the most profound of my life. We are psychically linked, she and I, and I have already warned her about you. She will not fall for your manipulations.
I only seek to talk to her.
I will not fall for your manipulations either. You showed restraint and reason on your journey here. Your choices reflect conscientiousness I've never witnessed in a Sith.
But you know,
the disparity in our capabilities is equal to the disparity in our age. You cannot win. Turn away now.
I've come too far to stop now.
What does it matter how far you've come if your life ends here?
I mean,
in me you face a full Jedi Master, and Yul Lee has greater command of lightsaber combat than any Jedi Knight I've trained.
color me nervous. Have we ever faced a full-fledged card-carrying Jedi Master before?
The Jedi have no idea how lethal you are, Vett.
I sense that's a bluff, but no matter. Your compatriot's query is moot, as you will be facing us on your own.
Well done, Master Yanlok. Now please, retreat and let me face the Sith.
Guys, your concern is appreciated, Yuli,
but I did not seize the advantage here to immediately relinquish it.
You don't fight fair, Jedi.
When the stakes are this high,
I am bound to do whatever it takes to preserve the order. Now for the last time, will you stand down?
Look, if the game would let me, I would.
Let me think about it.
Enough of this! It's useless to reason with the Sith.
Yul Lee, don't! Blazes, my hand is forced.
Guys, I really try. Buddy. I'm dying. You know, this wouldn't have happened if you didn't kill my healer. I'll be back. I can't even sell anything to offset my dead weight here. Hold on, do I have... I do not have a portable. God, that music is very insistent. There we go. Let me also get something out of collections. All right, Grandpa. I'm turning you down just a little. Let's try that. I wonder, will it let me cheat? Oh, that's a good idea. That's much more forward thinking what I was gonna go with. Alright. Hopefully now it'll let me. Change classes if I want to. But I'm thinking.
Why not?
I don't have mind maze, I don't think. No, I don't. I'm not high enough level. Let's bring out the big guns.
Just what? Can't stay this pretty without learning some tricks.
Hey, if you cheat, I can cheat too. You could heal me at any time. Oh, Jesus. I guess that's what, those med packs I always sell are for, huh? No, I don't want to go back to the med center. I'm not even gonna leave the fucking room. I don't want to reset the fight. I'm just gonna get as far away as I can. Which is, granted, not very far. I wonder if it'll reset if I go.
Look,
damn it, it probably does.
Helping.
Yeah, you were a big help, weren't you? Biggest fucking help. Grandpa! Alright, let me get that one. Alright, I will go look at... Oh, mind maze. That's in the wrong spot. That's where I would put mind maze. Oh, good! I only have to fight the one now. This only took me 3 times. I feel so ashamed. Alright, can we talk like civilized people now? You know what, Nico? No, you're done.
Fine by me.
Stop! Hold your weapon, Sith. I beg you.
You started this!
Stay your tongue.
No. She is just a Padawan. You are a great master. I must bargain for your life. Sith, I'll tell you everything I know, if you spare Master Yanlok.
Your devotion is remarkable.
I'm sorry, Master Yanlok. But I must do this. Her name is Jaysa Wilson, and Noman Carr has taken her to...
Yuli. You have no recollection of the Padawan this Sith seeks.
I have no recollection of the Padawan this Sith seeks.
No. Sleep. I do not relish wiping Yuli's mind like that, but his feelings for me got the better of him.
Most impressive.
It was a terrible thing, a last resort. I had to act for the greater good. Jaysa is special, her power unprecedented. If untouched by the likes of you, she has the potential to lead the Jedi to greatness.
You are filled with presumptions, Yon-Lark. I mean her no harm. Yon-Lark.
I know your mind, Sith. You twist the truth and manipulate weakness. I must err on the side of caution. You know Jace's name, but that is all you'll get here. So you may as well kill me. I must find tranquility, so Jaysa will sense only peace when you strike me down.
I refuse to deal the killing blow. Just tell her I want to talk.
You only wish to send a message? I am at a loss to understand you, Sith.
Look, Barriss is an asshole. We
because
all know
this. Because of the link
this.
We share, Jaysa knows what transpired here. Your message has been received. She will do with it what she will.
I leave you to wrestle with what you did to your fellow.
I do feel the shame of my actions. It will be difficult to live with. Goodbye, Sith. You've left me with much to ponder.
Well, the rumors are true. Being paralyzed is a blast. You put on quite a show. I knew you were good, but,
Hope you enjoyed yourself.
Not at all. It was infuriating not being able to wipe the sweat dripping from my nose. So, Sharik said she'd be at the ship. She thought we were done for. Can't wait to see the look on her face.
She will be surprised to see us.
I'll practice my smug look on the way there.
Her eyes will bug out. I told you.
See ya.
Not right now, Nico.
How's it going, my lord?
I have hope that you will surprise us all, Sith, and prove to be better than your order.
Poor Yuli. He's just like this big cuddly. Himbo of a man. I mean, granted, he, you know, came at me with a lightsaber, but who hasn't? That's just how people express their affection to Dane. He just has that effect on
Spraying
people.
All authorized destinations.
Things considered. I hear you, Twinkling Datacron, and I ignore you. Oh man, I need to look up how to find the runic. Apparently it's a little questy, the Datacron that's going to be on runic. Yeah. I remember I was here quite a while on the Inquisitor. One day I'll run the Empire storyline on Tatooine. I think it also ends up with Zerka zombies, doesn't it? I don't know, I've never read it, but I was under the impression that it ends up with Zerka zombies. Wait, where are you? Oh, there she is.
I never expected to see you again.
Yes, Eve, little thing.
Does this mean you ventured beyond the Forbidden Pass and found Master Yonlok?
Yep.
The mission is complete.
This is a great lesson. The only barriers that exist are the ones we create in our minds.
Yep, there really wasn't that much to it.
I will never again assume that I know all there is to know, and I will explore the entirety of the Tatooine Desert without reservation.
You have learned much from this.
I hope Lord Barriss knows how fortunate he is to have such a fine champion shepherding his cause.
Yeah.
I shall never forget you.
I'll remember you fondly as well.
Safe travels, my lord. If you're ever on Tatooine again, come and see me.
What doesn't end in circus zombies?
I hope I never come back to this sandy inferno. It's bad for my complexion.
Try not to be so self-absorbed.
Hey.
I never expect this.
I thought that was going to be nice and playful.
If we never return here, I won't miss it.
Glad we're on the same page.
Away we go! Time to go talk to Barriss.
You have done admirably, apprentice. Your time on Tatooine was well spent.
Yeah.
Norman Carr's Padawan Jaysa Wilson no longer enjoys anonymity. I am very pleased.
We haven't found her yet.
This is a lesson I do not need to be taught, youngster. Your handling of Master Yonlok has sent our enemies a clear message.
Uh-huh.
Noman Carr and Jaysa Wilson now know they cannot hide. It gnaws at the Master, and will bring his prized Padawan to her knees.
You certainly have a lot riding on that theory, Barriss.
Oh, don't doubt me. It's not a theory, apprentice.
I doubt you
only
a lot.
Only Alderaan remains. Jaysa Wilson's homeworld. Go there immediately. I will contact you when you arrive.
Guru and the dudes. Such a very specific layout and on way onto the bridge. Oh, I thought you wanted to talk, no? Other way. Sup?
You know, I never thought much about being a Twi'lek when I was younger. Even on Ryloth, there were lots of other types of people. As far as I could tell, people like me were just the ones who made the best slaves.
But
wasn't much to be proud of. you know?
Not having role models can make identity complicated.
You really surprise me sometimes. So mature.
Mm-hmm.
Not really what
Super
I'm used
mature.
To. When I left Nocturne's gang, I joined up with a group of Twi'lek artifact hunters. They were all young, too. Full of fire and Twi'lek pride. Out trying to recover our heritage.
I could see the appeal of young, excitable Twi'leks.
You should have met them. There was a girl they called Taunt. She was beautiful. Everyone loved her. I made friends in the new gang. But it wasn't until we did our first job together that we were family. There was this rich Dura scumball, Katablis. Obsessed with Twi'lek women, artifacts, clothes, anything. We took him for everything he was worth.
You said he was obsessed with Twi'lek women. Did you have to rescue people along with the loot?
Yeah, and some of them weren't exactly in great shape. Wasn't much better than Korriban, and they'd been there a while. Anyway, we were flying high. Did a couple more jobs together. Then came Korriban. And I guess you know how that ended up.
Oh, good chat. Sorry about your peeps.
Apprentice, I see you've touched down on Alderaan, Jaysa Wilson's home planet where Noman Carr found her. Excellent. You will discover everything you can about this Padawan and destroy everyone she loves there.
Again. Why?
What are we trying to achieve?
It is the same mandate as Tatooine. Assault Jaysa from afar. Stir her emotions. And flush her to the surface. Unfortunately, with the civil war for the Alderaanian throne raging, your contact, Duke Kendo of House Thule, has become unreliable. Kendo was supposed to find Jaysa Wilson's family for you, but it seems he's distracted. You must undistract him.
It's all agreements.
So, I have to mop up your mess.
Take care not to become one of my messes yourself, apprentice. Kendo is a political creature. The consequences of failing me are abstract for him. Once they are made concrete, he'll cooperate. You'll find him in the House Thule executive chambers. Make haste.
It's a shade of blue that just makes me want to click it. Aw, but Alderaan nobles are the best!
Nobody better
They're
mess
so
with us
spoiled.
Now.
We get the beautiful Alderaan music. I said that word weird. Alderaanian music. I'm kind of curious about what the Imperial storyline is.
Please select an available travel route. Have a safe and pleasant stay.
I wonder if I'm going the right direction. Looks like not. Oops. In the meantime, enjoy the beautiful Alderaanian countryside.
Destination? Enjoy your stay. Ready for departure.
Ah, look at those trees. And all the nerfs. Those beautiful mountains. But do we get to be a paladin of House Thule? Pretty.
You lack patience, Duke Kendo. There are standard procedures that must be adhered to.
Your disregard for our family rules is appalling. You are an abomination. Goodbye, cousin.
Fools. They won't be feeling much of anything for long.
Well...
Duke Kendo, Darth Barriss sent me.
What? You're not on my schedule. I don't appreciate being interrupted.
Oh, no.
Barriss isn't even on my radar, Sith. I have a war to wage and personal ambitions to achieve here.
Aiding Barriss may help you achieve those ambitions.
Please, don't try to manipulate me. I have Sith bodyguards of my own now. Tell Barriss I'm through being his lackey.
Oh, don't we all want to be free of him?
Show this intruder out. On his feet or his back, makes no difference to me.
I'm sorry, Duke Kendo. We are assigned to protect you and support your interests in the struggle for Alderaan. But we serve the Emperor first, and we will not cross Darth Barriss or his apprentice.
It's good to know some people have respect.
We consider you an ally, friend.
Okay. That was unexpected. It seems I may have been hasty regarding your master's needs. How can I make amends?
Don't be afraid. Barriss doesn't want you dead. For now.
Then I will endeavor to remain on his good side. I pledge the same level of focus that had me so absorbed in my own work. I pledge myself to your directives, and as I aid you, perhaps you'll be moved to help me in mine.
I'd say there's a very good chance of that.
Then you can consider me extremely motivated. As I recall, Darth Barriss wanted information on a young Alderaanian girl who was taken off-planet to train with Jedi Master Nomen Kar. I was to locate her family, so that you could, well, send the girl a message.
For your sake, I hope you were successful.
The truth is, information about this girl is difficult to come by. I managed only one lead. Nomen Kar's Padawan fits the description of the former handmaiden of a noblewoman in House Alder named Lady Renata. I've questioned her already, but Renata is protected by House Alder's greatest champion. The man has never met his match in melee.
There's nothing I can't handle.
If I may, once you've eliminated her protector and gotten what you need, I would personally be very indebted if you'd arrange to have Lady Renata brought to us for questioning.
I'll take it under consideration.
All right. I just hope the mood strikes you. While House Alder is a small player on Alderaan, it is affiliated with House Organa. Therefore, Lady Renata's estate is in hostile territory and very well defended. Be cautious.
Whatever you say.
Be ready for my return.
I do hope to see you soon. Until then...
Bye!
All better.
I believe Lady Renata of House Alder holds the key to finding the family of the Padawan you seek.
Why do I get the feeling? This is a wild goose chase. I'm getting tired.
Select an available travel route. Have a safe and pleasant stay.
Straight to time! So peaceful. So pretty. I just love the mountains. Music that's not screaming at me outright. Gonna go around the big kitty. Well, one of the big kitties. Bad kitty! Bad!
We go again.
You mean running away? That's what we do best. Not according to that. The party tried to start and then stopped itself. is us, gentlemen.
My lady, we have intruder.
Lady Renata, I seek the family of your former handmaiden, Jaysa Wilson.
What's this nonsense you're spouting? I don't know what you're talking about.
Lady, let me kill this Sith like the last one Duke Kendo sent.
Windred, you don't need my permission to kill an enemy that comes barging through my door. Make it fast.
Violence isn't necessary. I just need information.
All you need is my sword through your neck.
Aww. An even bigger himbo.
I'm sorry I ordered him to kill you, Sith. I hope you don't hold it against me. I've been fending off Duke Kendo's advances for some time. I just assumed you were here for him. If you're not working for the Duke, I'll gladly cooperate. You mentioned a girl, yes? Jaysa someone?
Glad to see I have your undivided attention.
You have a very persuasive manner. I was aware of the young handmaiden who left Alderaan with the Jedi Master. And I did hear the name Jaysa Wilsum, but you're mistaken. I didn't know her. The girl never served me.
Do you know anything about her?
Duke Kendo can include that in his interrogations. The Duke congratulates you on your impressive venture into House Alde. I'm here to take the fair lady to him.
No! Don't let him take me to that pig! I do know who the girl worked for. I'll tell you all I can, if only you'll keep me from Duke Kendo.
You have my attention.
Then we are agreed. Good. Before she left with the Jedi, Jaysa Wilsum was the handmaiden of Giselle Organa of House Organa. They were inseparable. Before the war, Giselle was an aristocrat like myself. Now she leads the Organan troops against House Ulgo.
That's an excellent lead. Thank you.
Stabbing myself through my shoulder.
How refreshing. You're welcome.
The Duke will know where to find Giselle Organa and how to reach her. If you let me deliver Lady Renata to him, I'm sure Kendo will happily shed light on the situation for you.
The lady isn't going anywhere.
Thank you. It's good to know some Sith have a sense of honor.
Fine. As I said, I will not oppose you, nor will I defy your decision here. I meant what I said. I'm sure Kendo can help you find and confront Giselle. You should consult with him on it.
Be sure he's prepared when I get there.
Of course, friend. I will see you at House Thule.
Despite the destruction you caused, I hold you in high esteem, Sith. I only hope you make that worm Kendo pay for misleading you. Take nothing he says at face value.
I appreciate your advice.
I'm sure you'll be fine. Goodbye.
Yeah, he probably needs a little culto after stabbing himself with a lightsaber.
We'll talk later. Promise.
Good to see that Barriss's men are... All of Barriss's allies are just as trustworthy as him. That's not a... I thought I saw green, but I just saw gold. Honey, I'm home.
I heard you decided not to allow Fimrest to bring the Lady Renata to me. I am most disappointed.
Well, seeing as how you lied.
You would have tired of her quickly.
Oh.
Oh. I saw what he was about to say.
I heard you...
Don't cry too hard. You'll get over it.
You don't know me very well. By denying my claim to Renata, you certainly aren't providing me much incentive to help you. Where's my motivation?
You need to become self-motivated, Kendo.
I prefer self-interested, but I see what you're saying. So, Fimrest tells me the lead was fruitful. Although Lady Renata was not the gold's mistress, she knew who was. Giselle Organa. I should say, General Giselle Organa. Now you have to track her down, which poses a bit of a problem.
If you can't solve the problem, you should be afraid.
Well, I'd better come up with a solution then.
Yes.
Giselle Organa leads the Organa War against House Ulgo. Her headquarters is protected by an impenetrable force field. No firepower can breach it. The force field allows Giselle and her advisors to be stationed very close to the front and maintain a more hands-on command.
Well, that's great.
Sounds like General Giselle knows what she's doing.
As smart as she is, there must be a way to overcome... Wait. Yes. A force field needs power to maintain itself, yes? So, if we manage to cut the power... And I bet I know exactly where Giselle is getting her juice. If I'm right, you could just walk through the front door.
Well, that sounds easy.
I find you hard to trust.
I've given you little reason to. I hope to remedy that.
Mm-hmm.
Almost all the power on Alderaan is supplied by the planetary generator. Giselle must be piggybacking the system to power her force field.
Mm-hmm.
Several of my fellows do this to maintain their special security needs. A precise charge at the generator will force failsafes to fire. The planet won't miss a beat, but ancillary systems like Giselle's force field will have to be manually reset, which could take some time.
What do you think of this plan?
Me? Wow, you want my opinion? Cool. I'll tell you, I just don't trust this guy.
What's a charming creature you are. Believe me, this is the only way to gain access to the Organa headquarters. Fimrest, fetch a 7-stroke-7 detonator from my arms cabinet there, and give it to our friend.
As you wish.
The Alderaan power generator is located above the Strait Valley, and it boasts the planet's most advanced security systems. You'll have to fight your way in, set the charge, then fight your way out before the boom. It won't be easy.
I'll try not to yawn too much.
Once you've detonated the generator, you'll still have to wade through Giselle's surrounding army and invade her headquarters before her force field is reset.
Sounds
fun. I'll be eagerly tracking your progress.
Uh-huh.
Good luck.
You're very creepy, my good sir.
To lower the force field that protects Giselle Organa's headquarters, you'll have to use the explosive I supplied you on the Alderaan power generator.
I misread that as courier dad instead of courier droid.
Welcome. Please select an available travel route. Have a safe and pleasant stay.
I'd already unlocked that one, hadn't I? Maybe I just like the soothing sounds of Thranta wings flapping in the wind. Damn, that's a long way. Alright, I guess we're going. Doing the long haul. Avoiding the kitties that do not like the party bus. As already proven. Very crooked here. Shortcut. We're taking a little river cruise. Oh, hey, look, an elevator we don't have to wait on. Progress. Hey guys, you got a leak up there, just so you know. Maybe wanna get someone to take a look at that. Running the power outage, aren't we? That's what happens if you don't fix the leaks in your roof. Gets into the electronics, just shorts everything out. It's a tragedy, really. You see me? I was invisible!
I'm going to haunt you.
That is a very obnoxious alarm. No, I'm not stopping. Oh, come on! I call party foul. Alright, let's see if it'll allow us to do this now. Well, we tried subtle. Subtle didn't work.
Our standing army outside is being wiped out.
Someone or something is on its way here.
My technicians almost have the force field reset, but we're still a sitting duck.
There have been several assassinations of House Thule officials.
Hey.
Security systems were down by the generator
that
explosion.
That face looks familiar.
In my opinion, House Ulgo is behind all this.
Your opinion is about to change. I'm here for information on Jaysa Wilson's family.
Intruder!
Giselle, get behind me.
None of you panic. I'll handle this. Sith, did I hear you right? You've perpetrated all this in search of my former handmaiden?
I doubt you would have taken my call.
It might have worked. I'm a practical woman. You have decimated my forces outside. They were to be deployed to secure a part of my front that's about to fall. Now I have no reinforcements. You seek information only I have, and my front needs bolstering. Perhaps we can help each other.
I'll defend your front, but tell me what I wish to know first.
I am not so gullible. I'll tell you about Jaysa Wilson's parents, after my front is defended. Now, on my left flank, there's a tunnel between my forces and House Ulgo's that has been hard-pressed by the enemy. I have only a ragtag troop defending this tunnel, and Ulgo is about to attack. You must repel the enemy forces.
I will accomplish it.
It is strange to say to a Sith, but you have my and House Organa's thanks. What's left of my forces at the tunnel choke point are being led by Lieutenant Dargus. I'll let Dargus know you're coming.
Not as
He'll
fun
contact
as the
me
name
as soon
is
as you succeeded.
Yarlok.
Assuming you do.
I won't disappoint you.
I have a good feeling you won't. Goodbye, Sith. As uncomfortable as it is to say, I hope we speak again soon.
One for the road. Oh, elevator. My oldest enemy and greatest nemesis. Did it just throw me off the elevator? You motherfucker. Burn this whole place to the ground. Oh, hey, they dropped something. Is that really necessary? Sorry, guys. Getting tired. I'm sorry, did I make you guys yawn too? Yes. My bad. Uh-oh. Drinking or driving? Cutting in and out, I'm not sure why, but... So we have to go take out the Olgo troopers. I am sure the Duke will be thrilled. Absolutely thrilled by this turn of events.
Alright, man. This is it. With the captain dead, it falls on me to rally what's left of us.
Aww, you can do it, little boy.
I guess the reinforcements aren't gonna make it. We'd better get ready. Ulgo forces are fast approaching. I can feel the tunnel walls shaking.
Then we shake the walls right back at them.
Lieutenant, we've been flanked.
No, wait. General Giselle sent word that a Sith would be coming to our aid, but I thought I must have misheard her.
Sir, I'm not trusting a Sith, no way.
We're drastically outnumbered, Sergeant. The General's given an order, and besides, without help, we die for sure.
The rest of the men and me aren't sticking around for a suicide run.
If you men follow the Sergeant, you'll miss a great victory.
If we stay, either Olgo kills us or the Sith does. Who's leaving with me?
I don't think so, Sarge. Maybe with the Sith at our side, we can repel the attack. Yeah, and I don't relish the idea of being a deserter anyway.
Glad to hear it, men. Sergeant, you are relieved, and I will report this to General Giselle personally.
Now you're sounding like a leader, Lieutenant.
Even though I understand the instinct to run, desertion can't be tolerated. Get out of here, Sergeant. Let the real soldiers fight the good fight.
Lieutenant, the Ulgo forces are coming now. What do we do?
Stand your ground and fight like men.
Take your positions. This is it.
There's four of them.
Trick.
is he doing up there? The fight's down here, sir. Well, how many of them survived? Oh, all of them. Well, good job.
That was amazing. They just kept coming and coming. And you're a war machine.
I appreciate your observation.
You might want to stop all the chatter. Those bozos are regrouping for another attack. Get ready.
Let them come. They'll find I'm more than their match.
Here they come.
Little faker. Which way are they coming from now? Oh, there they are. I miss my little fast travel. One of the sucky things about being low level. Do I have to go through all that again?
All better.
Is everybody dead? Oh no, I really have to do this all again.
All right, man.
Then we shake.
Lieutenant!
No, wait,
sir.
I am very disappointed.
Now,
even the get out. Lieutenant,
stand your ground.
Take your.
just, like, floats right back up to where he started. Now, mad. Now we're gonna get through this.
That was.
I appreciate. Let them come. They'll find I'm.
Here they come.
Maybe I won't stray too far this time. House Ulgo sucks.
There's blood all over me. It's everywhere. Everywhere!
Calm down, Lieutenant. Your wounds are superficial.
Hey, I just snuck a peek into the tunnel. There's a heap of those laser brains getting ready for another swipe.
Let's stay sharp.
Get ready to be overrun.
More. Alrighty. Oh, that's a big boy. I'm going to haunt you. See if this is actually the end. Well, the cheering seems to make me think so.
It's a miracle! The Ulgo forces are retreating!
This guy!
You did it!
I couldn't have done it without you, Lieutenant.
You are too kind, Sith. I'll get General Giselle on the holo for you. She'll be very relieved.
What's the word, Dargus? I assume that since you're hailing me, the day is won?
Yes, General. The Sith single-handedly turned back the entire attack.
Sith, as painful as it has been, it seems you've come through. I hope you're not expecting a thank you.
War makes strange bedfellows.
This experience has certainly proven that. Now, I promise to tell you where Jaysa Wilson's parents could be found. They have been servants in Castle Organa for many years. Sif, the Wilsons are simple, innocent, hard-working people. They deserve your mercy.
I'll take it under consideration.
That's all I can ask.
Goodbye, Sif. And thanks for saving my life.
You should probably find a different job, buddy. I'd stop now, but there's no easy way to get back here. So we press onwards. We have to go sneak into Castle Organa. No problem. Come on, party bus! Oh. So close, but so far. Going to Castle Organa. I thought, This seems like a different area, though. Is this the back of it? Uh-oh, someone, beat me here. Well, we've got quite the welcoming party.
General Jessa's warning was true. The Sith has come for us.
Men, rally around me. The fight is upon us.
didn't think a single assailant could make it through Castle Organa's defenses all the way here to us.
Well, sneaking helped. A lot.
The Organa guards are well trained. It was quite a challenge.
It will feel like child's play compared to facing me, Sith. You will not harm Parvin and Gregor Wilson. I vow it.
No one has to get hurt over this.
So, you murdered countless innocents to get here, and now you want to make friends.
Please, Master Jedi.
I didn't murder anyone!
I realize the Sith can't be trusted, but I want to hear this.
Fine. Say your piece, Sith. I'm not going anywhere, and I will protect them, no matter what.
I'm here to do things for them, not to them.
Then there's no need for further violence. Sith, what is it you want?
Gregor, this has to do with Jaysa. I just know it.
Yes, I'm here because of your daughter.
I knew she shouldn't have gone with the Jedi. Now the Empire is hunting her. Sith, Jaysa was our life. She was going to marry Organa nobility so that we would no longer have to be servants.
When she left, we sacrificed that dream. We don't know anything about Jaysa now. We were told we would probably never see her again. We are mere servants. What could you want with us?
I'm here to deliver you from servitude.
You want to help us?
No, Gregor. The Sith is toying with us before killing us.
Heed your wife's warning, Gregor Wilson. Sith are devious and demented.
Is that what you mean, Sith? By killing us, you end our life of servitude? Can't you spare us?
I really don't want him to serve the Emperor.
You'll survive the day if you become my subjects.
What do you mean by this? What is to happen to us if we do as you say?
I'll see to it that you live like kings.
Dirty, no good Cretan!
Parvin, Jaysa has gone off to a life of discipline and detachment. We are unlikely to ever see her again. The Sith is offering us a way out of this, a way to live.
Jaysa is sensitive, Gregor. She will feel our betrayal. It will fester in her. Don't you see? This Sith is banking on that.
Did you hear me say you'll live like kings?
My wife can't see the big picture. You offer a choice between death or pledging ourselves to our daughter's enemy. I choose that Parvin and I live in the arms of the Empire, and I trust that my daughter will understand and remain strong.
A wise approach.
Please, my sweet, stand with me on this.
My place is with you, Gregor. As long as we're alive, there's hope.
We are in agreement. We shall embrace the Empire. Tell us what happens next.
You'll receive instructions at the Imperial Landing.
I'm so glad you've all found an accord. But there's still the matter of you being our enemy, Sith. Will I not allow the Wilsons to do this, but you had yourself a killing spree getting here.
I really did.
And that can't go unpunished.
This is a peaceful solution, Jedi. Honor it.
Yes, Master Volrider. Stay true to the Jedi Code and keep the peace. Too many have died already today.
Gregor and I go of our own free will and spare this house any further pain.
This doesn't sit right. But I can't attack someone walking in peace. Even a Sith.
You just saved your life.
The code is everything, Sith. But I wouldn't expect you to respect it.
He doesn't even really
expect
the
Sith code.
Leave out
the back door to avoid further casualties.
Fine.
I'll say nothing further.
Apprentice, the Sith Fenris who attends Duke Kendo was able to patch me through to you directly. Excellent.
Yeah.
I am seeking an update. News of your search for Jaysa Wilson's family has reached me, and I am quite concerned.
Relax, old man. All is under control.
That's not what I am hearing. Duke Kendo contacted me to tell me that you have been busying yourself with personal exploits and disregarding my mission.
You believed him? He's a fool.
I know to take him with a grain of salt, but you've been there for some time.
Not really that
Tell me you found the family of Noman Kar's Padawan. Tell me they have been taken care of.
You insult me by insinuating otherwise.
Then all is well. Good. No doubt the Padawan is twisting with grief.
Twisting.
You eclipse my greatest hopes for you and prove you belong at my side. Which makes my susceptibility to Duke Kendo's gossip about you all the more foolish.
Let the fool have his little amusements.
But they come at your expense, apprentice. First off, Kendo said that you set an explosion that caused the death of several Thule dignitaries.
That was his doing, not mine.
It must be politically advantageous for him to disavow his role in such a thing. Kendo also said that you helped the Republic defend their front in Organa's war against House Ulgo, painting you as a traitor.
You know I'm no traitor.
It would surprise me to discover such a thing, but I cannot assume anything for certain. All that matters to me is that your mission is complete. For whatever reason, the man has taken it upon himself to slander you. I have no further use for Duke Kendo. Punish him however you please. If it were me, he'd pay severely.
I'm impervious to his antics.
Do what you will, but quickly. Until we destroy the threat of Jason Wilson, nothing else
Just
is important.
Such a threat.
Goodbye, apprentice.
Such a threat. Well, he brought this upon himself. Can't say we didn't try. That door that always fools me. I'll give the Duke a chance. Even though he's a creepy old
come
man.
Come in. I heard of your success and I'm so very pleased for you.
You told Barriss I murdered your rivals, and you called me a traitor.
Oh, I see. How awkward for me. Allow me to explain. I realized when you blew up the power generator, several of my rivals would be exposed. So I seized the opportunity to eliminate them. Mm-hmm. I had company when I was speaking with your master, and I needed to keep my fellow house members blind to my maneuvering.
That is a lie. You contacted Barriss yourself, alone.
The truth comes out.
I only wanted Barriss to know that I was looking out for him. It was harmless. I knew you would succeed, and all Barriss would care about was that. Please don't kill me. Fimres, you and your men are assigned to me. If I am attacked, you must defend.
If Darth Barriss's apprentice decides you die, we will not intercede.
No one dies today, but he must leave Alderaan forever.
I'd give up everything I've worked so hard for.
Well, shouldn't have been a dick.
That is your punishment.
Very stiff and painful one.
Better
I will
than
leave
death.
This planet, my home, immediately. A broken man.
Oh, you're breaking my heart.
I know there is no sympathy for me. Goodbye, Sith. I shall never return to this place.
And Alderaan will
sad,
be all the better
pathetic
for it.
Man. Serving him was a daily dose of nausea.
I can imagine.
Now we report back to our master on the Council. We will be paying attention to your exploits. Farewell.
Well, bye, I guess. Where you guys all going? I'm just trying to kill as few people as possible. Thankfully, the writing on this storyline is not nearly as frustrating as Inquisitor.
You crushed Alderaan under your boot, Apprentice. I am incredibly impressed. The planet will feel the sting for years to come.
I am your humble servant, Master.
Noman Kar's Padawan can no longer hide in anonymity. I am pleased. By rooting out this Jaesa Wilson's parents, you have reached across the galaxy to strike a sharp blow at our enemies.
Uh-huh.
Every lead followed perfectly, every planet ravaged. Our adversary is growing antsy, I can feel it. Expect news soon. Barriss out.
Bye.
My lord, I thought it prudent not to interrupt Darth Barriss. We received a recorded transmission. It is queued when you are ready.
Sith, I'm Jaesa Wilson. My master, Noman Kar, has no idea I'm sending this message. Let's be real. We both know this isn't about us.
Ah, the hunted seeks the hunter.
Our masters pretend otherwise, but this is personal. You and I are only pawns in their private war, and those I care about are caught in the middle. It has to stop.
Wow, gotta give it to her. She sure got guts.
She certainly does.
I appreciate directness. And as merciful as your actions have been, it's time you stopped this passive-aggressive campaign. This message includes coordinates where I'll be waiting in my ship. Let's discuss this face-to-face. No more nonsense.
What do you think of that, Captain?
It could be a trap, my lord. Noman Kar may have put her up to it.
Hey, don't listen to Captain Paranoid here. I don't think it's a trap. I trust her.
Thanks for the input, Vert.
The coordinates are set, my lord. We can rendezvous with her ship whenever you give the word.
Yeah, in a bit. And by that, I mean next time. Oh, and everybody wants to talk, so I suppose we'll have our little final chats before we go to bed. What's up? Have fun with your little spy hunt.
My lord, my efforts to locate SIS Agent Vollerin have finally paid off. There is a small window of opportunity to confront him.
Okay, have
fun. I can handle the matter personally. Permission to intercept and bring him down.
All Imperial concerns sound the same to me. Refresh my memory.
Vollerin is the SIS agent I would have caught years ago, but Moff Broisk unwittingly stopped me. This agent continues to cause the Empire untold losses. I finally tracked him down, my lord.
Uh-huh.
He's scheduled for extraction. If that happens, the trail will be lost. And all the intel he's acquired will be compromised.
This brings your priorities into question, Quinn.
Your missions are priority one, my lord. My duties here are complete, and this won't take long. The Empire will finally be served. I'll return shortly.
Well, sorry, Mr. SIS Agent, I tried.
My lord, I'm back from my mission. I'm pleased to report Agent Vollerin's decade of espionage has been brought to an end. It is a great day for the Empire.
Just another Republic spy. I'm sure there will be others.
No doubt. But none that have caused the Empire such difficulty.
Thank you for allowing me to pursue this, my lord.
You kind of just did it on your own, but okay.
Don't make more out of it than it was, Captain.
You're very gracious, my lord. Is there anything you require at this time?
No. No, you're good.
Carry on, Captain.
By all means, my lord.
Want to talk more about your past?
You're never going to guess what I've been doing. No, no, don't try. I'll tell you. In between jumps, I've been checking holo frequencies, and I found the old gang. They're on Nar Shaddaa.
They just left you on Dromacos?
They weren't leaving messages for me in the old spots. I thought they got themselves caught, or dead, or something.
Are you thinking of going back to your old life?
What? Are you worried I'll leave you? Old gang's been on the run since I've been gone. Apparently our mysterious informant for the Korriban job was that scumsucker Kata Bliss. Bliss sure got revenge for the job we pulled on him. Fake mission, fake cover story. I'm thrown in the slave pens, and he hits the gang hard.
So you could say he was our matchmaker?
You are so weird. Once they escaped the mercenaries, Taunt and what's left of the old gang spent their last credits tracking Kata Bliss's movements. That Duro snake has managed to get his hands on the Star of Kalaun. It's a priceless piece of Twi'lek history. I want to get it back.
Tell me where we're going, and I'm with you.
You're fantastic! Kata Bliss is at the spaceport on Nar Shaddaa, trying to line up a buyer. I'll send a message that we're coming. Make us out to be interested buyers. Oh, and I'll tell the gang to get ready to receive the artifact. Bliss has some famous Kalish bodyguard they call the Virus working for him these days.
The Virus.
But that's not going to worry you, is it?
Yeah, I'll forget it by next week.
So what happens now?
Well, I think this is a good spot to leave off for the night. Thank you guys for coming out. It was a lot of fun. We will probably be back next Saturday. Same bat time. Maybe the same bat channel. And until then, enjoy the new patch. And I'll see you guys on the flip side. Good night.
It's been a pleasure.